So, time has come to say farewell to all of you. I must say, this time our tour has been really very successful. There have been no obstructions, no problems, nothing. Except for one stupid article, we had no problem, and which they are going to look after. On the whole, we have learnt a lot this time, and I think everybody has been feeling very much better because of Shivratri Puja. I've got reports from other countries that they said, Mother, what did you do this time on Shivratri that we all felt so much higher and better? Let's put it down. Now the few things I have to tell you, that luckily you have a very good national leader here who has brought you all round, very wise person. And he is a very gentle as well as very sensible person, and who has done it will fall down otherwise. Such a good work that really I must say it's very remarkable. And now I have decided to separate his work with national, what's the sign? Yes, thank you. See, Indians feel very hot anyway. We have too much of sun within us, I think. So, there, one has to be thankful for that you have such a nice leader here. I have to tell all the people, especially from Melbourne, that you should not take things into your hands and start another sort of an organization arbitrarily doing something under some lady like that Trish. If you have any problems, you can always write to me. I have told so many times, but Australians don't write to me is my main complaint about them. And they should not start anything. I'm surprised that there are so many Indian girls in Melbourne, and they also did not understand that they have to write to me. So once you are caught up, you get lost, you get vibrations in a very funny way, so much so that I can't even really treat them in this short time. So there is a list of people. Can you bring the list? I made the list now. Please write it down. Is there anybody from Melbourne here? Yes. Go and tell them that you have to get all these people every day to sit down, Sunday morning maybe, and see what sort of vibrations you have. You can see it on the candle. There's not to go anywhere. Just on the candle you can understand what's wrong with you, Chashmalayana. What's wrong with you? And you are getting caught up. I'm surprised that you are supposed to be Sir Yogi. How could you not feel the vibrations of this woman, Trish? It took me not even a second to know that she is a Bhoot. But there's a fraternity, I think. That's why such nice Sir Yogis, beautiful Sir Yogis, got involved into it. So this is a very serious thing, and I hope this doesn't happen next time. Now the list is like this. I made the list. Can somebody read it for me? Please. Take it.
Michael Davies, Jackie Hodge, Peter Hodge. We give them a photocopy of this. John Poulianakis, Fred Miller, Ian Lowry, Greg Bradshaw, Lyndon Duval, Philip Noon, Martin Purcell, Colin Berry,
Jeff Platford, Bruno Ocello, Glenn, what's this word? Pulalovich, Ben Flora, Savita Noon, Cheryl Bradshaw, and Helen Platford.
They are all first-class surgeons, I tell you, all of them. And it's really beyond me. Even when he's reading the thing, I'm getting on the left. You just see, you'll feel it. Terrible, getting the pain here. Now, how are they going to be all right? I'm worried about them. Now, also in Melbourne, I thought I'm sending a very, very good, sensible leader. I don't know why people got after him and formed a group outside. If I am sending somebody, I should know that I know what I am doing. So you become anti-me or what? So please, all those people who have got these problems, work it out every night, every morning on the three canal treatment. And you can go in the garden, sit down there, also say Ganesha's mantras. It will take some time for you to be all right. I can tell you. Even taking their names, you get left suggestion. Aren't you getting the left suggestion? The whole left. This can happen to anyone. Because somebody like that comes up and starts her own. Anything without the leader should not be done. They went to such a limit that they have taken out the name out of the list of telephone of these people. Can you imagine? This is too arbitrary. It's very dangerous. It should not happen anymore. People are very good at combining together when it is some sort of a negativity. You see, if you want to hate someone, immediately fundamentalists will join together to hate someone. Now for Adelaide, I would say, Adelaide has one problem also. People are very arbitrary. They have given me lots of trouble before. And if they want me to come back, now I have asked Michael Sweet, because he's quite good at organizing, to organize all the people in Adelaide. And please support him. Now don't get after his life now. That shows that the leaders who are unscrupulous, who are dishonest, are more appreciated and can dominate people. While those who are good, nice people are to be dominated. So please in Adelaide, unless and until you have an ashram, I am not going to come there. Get an ashram, all of you shift to the ashram and work it out. If 25 people, Sahayogis, cannot live together, how do I expect the whole world to be there? Just think of our vision. Then Wollongong, another thing. The other day we had very nice people. I don't know how Sahayogis are working out Wollongong. They have to have a proper ashram, no individual houses. Same in Newcastle. You all can have a big house. Now these are the best days when you can take a house on rent. Such a godsend thing now for us that you can really get a house for such a cheap price. Take a big house outside the city somewhere, not in the city, and sit down with your meditation. I hope you must have realized that a very great work we are doing in Sahayoga, the greatest of greatest. And you are all part and parcel of that. So please try to find out methods by which you all could be closer and understanding each other, loving each other. Also, beware of Indian girls. In this respect, they have a tendency, that's what everybody is informing, that they always want to separate out, and Indian boys also. Otherwise, they are all right. But one of the reasons I know now why it is, that, you see, the girls or the boys from the West have led a different type of a life, a very different culture. It's, we can say it's not such. And they try to tell them what kind of a life they have led. And that makes them very miserable and they develop a nausea with that. Then they are frightened. You don't have to discuss these things with anyone. Past is finished. Why do you want to talk of that filth now? So, nobody has to discuss about the filth through which they have come out. Do you mean to say that when the lotuses come out, do they talk or do they smell of the filth out of which they have come out? No, they spread fragrance. In the same way, now your lotuses, try to assume your powers. Even if you put somebody on the throne and make him king, still he is in a beggarish way. Everybody comes, he says, give me $1, then what to say? It's the same situation. Now you are out of it, finished now. So don't discuss these dirty things and filthy things. That's why these Indians are frightened, because there is a cultural difference. And they want to run away. So if you don't talk about it, they'll be all right. Don't discuss. It's filthy, it's dirty, why to discuss it? I've told 100 times when you are getting married, not to talk about your past. There's no confession and all that in Sahaja, you know very well. And people write to me, I will be surprised, 12 pages, 14 pages of their confessions. I'm trying. I don't read even one word out of it, because immediately I know the filth is there. Burn it off. So no use writing to me also. I don't want to know. Finished. I don't know. Why? What is the need for you to write all this? There's no need to write. All right? After all, you are my children. How you are born is important. Then from where you came is not important. You are all beautiful people. I have already told you what you are. Believe me, you can check out whatever I have said is true or not. Also, I have told you, as I work without taking any money, you too work without taking any money, don't you? So please don't discuss these things. It's not worth discussing, talking, filth. If some outsider starts, tell them, we don't want to talk about it, it's finished now, it's gone. That's how things are working out now, properly. You see, I depend on you very much for one reason, that you are from Ganesha's country. If you just know how to forget it, it can be worked out. You are Sri Ganesha's, in the sense that you are now innocent. Innocence is born within you. There's a fragrance of innocence. Why do you want to remember those dirty things? Now I'm telling you again, if I hear from anyone that anyone is discussing this, then we'll ask them to get out of Sahaja. Because why do they want to remember the filth? Again, go back to the same filth then. All right? This is not to be done again, please. So now we'll come to another point of schooling the children. I find that still people are very money oriented as far as the school is concerned. Very money oriented. Very. Now for Indian schools, we have calculated how much money will be needed. And we have to also spend some money for equipping that, to equip that school. Nobody is eating money there, for heaven's sake. As soon as it comes to Indians, immediately we will say, he eats money. And when so many have eaten money in here, Australians, nobody even thought that they will eat one. So, try to understand, it's much less the price that you are paying here, even for preschool. While not only it's education, but also food, also other amenities, they have to travel and this. There is some little profit if they get, will be good idea, so that we can equip them. Now we have to build a high school. Who is going to pay for the building? It's school for your children, not for Indian children. Who is going to pay? So that is it. We have to have for even for middle school, that is after the 6th or 7th, that what you call this 6th class, we call it, or 5th class, we have to have computer. They have to learn about computer. Indian schools are not like this. They have to have a science laboratory. If you see the subjects they have to learn, you'll be amazed. English, they have to know grammar very well. They must have proper spellings, proper handwritings. This is the minimum. I am saying the minimum of minimum. My grandson was studying in a school. It's a very well-known school, Doon School, and they were paying much more there. It's a very famous. We have private schools, which we call them as public schools. And they are all somewhere away from the cities. He was paying much more. But when he joined another school in Delhi, which is a day scholar, he had to pay 75,000 rupees only to enroll himself. And every month he is paying 10,000 rupees when he is just a day scholar in Delhi. And this school is going to be much better, much more equipped, various things will be doing. But every time I find such a money orientation about schools. Same about preschool, I've seen it. See, we must understand that children are to be educated by us. The first thing is you should never doubt the teachers. No way. You must respect. This is what is lacking in your education here. That's why children have no respect for anyone. I told you the story again, I'll tell you the same story, that my father had a generous habits of educating boys from poor classes. That all we do. If we have money, we just don't put it for ourselves and indulge into it, but we always try to help our poor relations or poor people. So he always had 4 or 5 boys studying. They stayed in our house and we looked after them. One of them did his matriculation when he was doing his intermediate. He felt a little obliged and he said, "Sir, if you allow me, I would like to teach your children." He said, "All right, go ahead." We had two gates to enter the house. One which went through the courtyard, another through his office. One day, I don't know why, he came through his office and immediately my father stood up for him. He was extremely embarrassed, you see, didn't know, he just thought, everybody got up. Who is this gentleman has come? Then he went inside and he told my mother that, "I touch your feet, but tell Sahab not to get up for me, it is too much, I can't just bear it." My father came in. He said, "Why should you be embarrassed? If I don't respect you, then my children won't respect you. You must try to be nobler people. These ignoble habits should be given up, otherwise your children will be ignoble." Now, whatever has to be paid to the teachers has to be paid. Apart from that, sometimes you must, in the presence of children, you must try to give them some presents or some flowers. Respect them. That's what they do in India. And while most of the rich people donate money, absolutely, if they have more money, they donate money to the schools. That's the sign of a noble person. For a Sahajogi, it is important. Supposing now we have somebody who doesn't have money or maybe not a job, and he cannot educate. Now this is a good Sahajyogi who has been in Sahajyoga for 2-3 years, has been giving realizations to people, but he doesn't have a job. It's our duty in a way to support his children to be educated. See, when this hand is self-supporting, is all right. And when this is self-supporting, is all right. But in case it needs the support of this, this has to give the support. As we call scholarships, or sometimes we call. Now we have got at least 5 or 6 children in our school there who are absolutely free, absolutely food. Some of them I am supporting, some of them Yogi is supporting, and some of them are absolutely free, absolutely 100%. Will not tell you the names. Their food, their clothes, everything, and nobody knows. We don't want them to develop a feeling. So all the time to be very calculating about things is bad. I've seen a complete manifesto typed or matter, I don't know what, about having a committee on top of this little preschool. That is not proper. That's, it's conditioning everything. Even if you have to put these balloons, you'll have a committee. This committee, on top of that, another committee, another. Trust, trust and trust. We have now one committee, I had to do it, is called as the finance committee. All right. They are all audits, experts and accountants, and they will be here in Sydney. That doesn't mean Sydney is dominating as someone. Some subjects have to be central. As in any government, that you should understand, and that these can go and see your accounts if they are all right or not. But nobody has to dominate in such. We have to help, support and trust. Now, in this preschool, I find there are only 7 children of that age group who are studying. There are smaller children also. I have suggested to him that why not use this area for the school, there's a school there, and I would like children to be in my room than anybody else. So use this. You save money like that, and children will feel comforted. Everybody should see, if they have time, what can I do for children? Can I come and help you? Instead of that, how much money you spend, is that. See, there's no income tax in Sahajyoga, is there? You want to get rid of these kind of things, everybody feels frightened and insecure all the time. Forget about these things. Trust. You don't know how many thousands of dollars I have lost by trusting. Thousands. Well, we have to trust. What can you do? We have to pay for our principles. The main principle is trusting and not to ask about money, where is what is that. The second is a very bad situation here is because every parent can go and interfere with the teacher because they think they are paying for it. You will spoil your children completely. Should never, never interfere with the teachers. Never. With the school. I mean, if you don't have money, all right. Some, again, you can have a committee to find out if they really don't have money or not. But if somebody says, I have no money, I have no job, all right. Somebody should help. But it should not be a kind of a police force behind these teachers or behind the school or behind the leader. Where is the money gone? Where is that gone? This, that. Those who worry too much of money will never have money, I tell you. Though I lose money quite a lot, but I get double, I tell you. Never a problem. I never have a problem of money. Never, never, never. One must trust. I'll tell you one example. Very nice example. It shows how Sahajyoga works out things. I went down to Rome and we wanted to start a school in Rome. We saw the land, everything is very nice, but we had to deposit the money immediately. And Guido said, Mother, we need about 16,000 pounds worth of liras to deposit this. I said, I don't know if I have that money with me in the bank or not. I'll have to see. But it doesn't matter. I reached the airport and I was leaving. Suddenly, Sandra came with a packet and she said, Mother, this I have saved for you. I said, what is this? This is money, liras. I said, but why? I don't take any money. Why do you give me? Suddenly it struck me, how much it is? What is the value? She said, 16,000 pounds. I said, that's it. So I got that money from her. I said, all right, give me, I'll take it. And gave it to Guido. I said, Guido, go and book your. He booked that. Then it so happened that the whole thing fizzled out and he got back his money again, like a back penny. So we were starting the shurika. I went there. Guido said, Mother, don't change your money. I've got all these liras with me. All the things that I had to buy were bathroom fittings and all the, what you call, the WCs and all that, plus the all the marble and all the curtains and whatnot, every sort of thing. And do you know, in one day I did all that, for such a big place like Shuri, in one day, really. It was a fast movement. And after that, I told them that you pay them and send me the bill, whatever. I also gave them 100 pounds more. I said, these curtains are very nice, also get some more for me maybe, because they are dark shade. And can you imagine, when the bill came, it was 16,100 pounds. Exactly. So I had forgotten about 100. I said, how is it 16,000? What have you done? Must be some manipulation. He said, Mother, no, it's grace of God. It has worked out. I said, then this 100 from where? It's yours. You gave us. You forgot. This is yours. Then we bought the land and sold it for double the price, and now they have an ash. But where people are stingy about money, think about money, things do not work out. And also worth knowing, when we bought these two very big ashrams in Rome, I don't know if anybody has seen them, yeah? Very big two ashrams we've got them. That too, I told him, just be on the lookout. She said, Mother, there is one advertisement for a house nearer the main road or something. I said, main road won't be good. No, no, it's quite in the inside, but it's away from the main city. I said, have you seen it? No. But I said, I have no time now, you're telling me now. And I have to catch the plane. I said, Mother, I had no time to tell you. Luckily that day we heard that the plane was cancelled because there was some trouble. I said, very good. Now we have got one day. I said, can you talk to the owner and ask him if he would like to show me the place? The owner accepted. And we went there about 3 o'clock. Reached there about 3. My plane was about 8 to India. So immediately I saw this. And that amount which we had spent, I mean, we for the buying of the land had doubled, and we could buy both the houses. And it's such a big land. Immediately I said, buy it now. We bought it and I caught my plane and went to it. Nobody will believe that in such a short time we got that beautiful. It's a very, very beautiful school and also very beautiful area. Just see, it worked out. So I have a feeling that when you start worrying about money, it slips out somehow. Nothing works out. To feel the grace is to leave everything to God. Now you do it, I don't know. You'll be amazed how things work out. It's beautifully it works out and you are amazed because that's how you know that you have the blessings. How God has blessed you. Money is what? Is the dust of His feet. So, I told you when I came, these people, customs troubled me. I said, I don't know what they are going to have now here in this session. But doesn't matter. It's not going to affect you at all. If you are in a witness state, you can see all that. And things will work out. Everybody will have sufficient money. But don't worry. And the more money people have, the more they are worried about money. I have seen that. Those who have less, in any case, they know that they have less. So what is there to worry? Like me. But about school now. We have 3 classes. And I wanted to talk to Stephen. Let him solve the problem. If you find anything wrong, you can tell him. But no parents should go and disturb the teachers. Absolutely. You have no right to do that. Even, I would say, Indian school. Nicely, all the people go, stay there, this. In which school is it allowed like this? After this, all those who have to see their children have to stay in a hotel and see them only on a particular date which is being told that you have to see. You will be disturbing your children all the time. It's not that anybody can go anytime, live there nicely and interfere with the working of the school. We have to bring some system into it. Otherwise, your children will suffer. Even the Dharamshala school was really absolutely, there were a visitation of all these Bhutish people. They tortured the lives of these teachers there. This is never done. So now, next time, nobody is going to go there like this. I have told him that you, if they are going to Dharamshala, then they should stay in a hostel. And the children can also stay with you. In a, not hostel, we can call it a kind of a inn or it is a can call it, what is it? It's not a big hotel, but a kind of an inn sort of thing. You can take your children there with you. But you should not go to the school all the time and sit with them. Because even there, they have to study. The trouble is, Indian standards are very high. All the children, though they have holidays, only take holidays for 1 month. And the rest of the time, they are all studying. See how your children will improve. They don't know even how to spell C-A-T, cat. Because of the interference of the parents, children are so bad. So now, if you have real love for your children, allow them to grow properly. And you'll see how they'll come up. Another thing, they have no immunity for anything. Like if there's any jaundice, they are the first to get it. If there's malaria, they are the first to get it. If there's typhoid, they are first to get it. While Indian children have that immunity. Because I've seen here also, everybody is carrying the child. Don't touch the child all the time. Keep the child away from you. Your body has that warmth which goes to the child also. Yes, sometimes you have to look after the child. The child must know you love the child. But all the time carrying the child like this, I have seen many ladies who are in my lecture also being like this. Why? What is the need? You make the child so much conditioned and the child cannot remain quiet and listen to you do like this. Massage the child nicely. Massaging is very good. You should massage yourselves also, but at least the child. Let them learn how to take bath. Every day. Every day they must be cleansed so that they develop the habit of cleanliness. They never wash their hands. They don't want to wash their hands. And their hands smell. They just use paper. Whatever you tell them, they'll use paper, never wash their hands. The hands smell. mouth smells. With all your development, children have no sense of personal cleanliness. We have to know that they are born realized and that they have to have a very different type of attitude towards life. As the same way as the parents have to have a very different attitude towards the school. It's a very patronizing. And you should be proud that you have such a school here. Thank God they are not in the same mess as you have been. It's so much protection to them. So change your attitude entirely about the schools, about the children, and look after them as if you are their trustees. They are in your trust, and also they should know that you love them very much, as anybody else also loves them. They must learn how to respect, they must have good manners. This can be done when the children are here, because they don't know how to say namaste, they don't want to say thank you, they don't want to say sorry, nothing of the kind. All the time they'll go and ask, why? Why? When the Indian teachers start looking, Indian children would not. Yeah, they have no right to ask. They will all be brats here, tell you, all the children who are going to all these schools, whether private or to the municipal schools. But the other schools that are where this horrible schools are there here, I know. Because anybody who comes from those schools, we don't want to admit them. We have had 3 of them, we sent them back. It's cheaper, all right, but we can't admit. 3 children have been sent away. If you feel that you must share your money with your children, then see that they get proper education, proper grounding. Of course, I'm going to make a proper complete sketch of how, with the teachers, how to deal with the children, how to make them understand, how to put them into proper. This is a very, very important age, from 3 to 5 years, I think. Till 1 year, they should be with the mother and father. But mother should not too much also all the time handle the child, and should look after the child in a way as if it is in her trust. Massage the child, look after the child. I have seen some children just go on crying. I don't know, maybe the mothers must have been very unhappy when they were bearing the child. Maybe they had a bad time with the mother-in-law, maybe with the husband, whatever it is. All the time crying. All right, that can be corrected. But they are our property and we have to look after them. But again I say, that doesn't mean that a mother should expect others to give bath or look after them all the time. It's not so. So I hope you'll use your discretion now. As far as your children are concerned, I am very much concerned about it. Now the story goes about, people start talking like that. About the Indian school, there's a lot of criticism. I would like to know how much you have paid for the school to build. It's only your children studying there, nobody else's. How much money did you pay to buy the land? Nobody inquired. How much it has cost to build this school? Nobody inquired. But if you are sending about $15 fees there for their food and everything, dollar kitna? $150 for 4 weeks. Where they eat their food, live there, they have all facilities, everything, plus their education. But that will be very much discussed. You have to know that it's a very big headache to teach the Western children in India, because every money has to be accounted for. Our FERA means foreign exchange regulations, and every 6 months we have to give the report to the Reserve Bank of India how we are spending this foreign exchange. they are experts. Despite all that, the people, loose tongues, are saying somebody is eating the money there. It's very difficult. You don't know. To manage the Western children in India, first of all, as they are, and then secondly, that the government is on top of her head, they are sitting. Then third is about food. Your children are used to tinned foods. Like they'll say, we want baked beans in the morning. We want this, we want that. Every child wants something else. Now the people will go crazy cooking for all of them separately. You have agreed to such a thing. All right, you want this, have it. You should not compromise. No, better eat this. He won't eat today, he'll eat tomorrow. Whatever is cooked for everybody in the family, please have it. And these tinned fruits, I am absolutely against it, and I am sure you also don't want them to have tinned fruits. They want to have fried fish and baked beans and potato chips. That's all they know about food, nothing more or less. So don't send them any tinned fruits. Foods. Tinned fruits. I think you better not send them any food is a better idea. Because if you send them chocolates, their liver will be spoiled. They are getting everything there. So please, if you have to give, you can give them clothes or anything, but not something to eat. Somebody brought lots of chocolates. That's how they got this problem. Chocolates should be avoided for children up to some age. And also ice cream. But ice cream still is not so much fat, but chocolate special. You can have lollipops and all those things are perfectly all right. Lollies are all right. Be careful as to what habits you give to them. And tinned food should never be given to children. It's very bad. It there's some preservation. And for that preservation, they put some chemicals. And that's why the children are very susceptible. They have no immunity. It's easy to get fresh things here. Not difficult, especially in Australia. You have no problem. Get them fresh things. Fresh fruits, fresh food. You should give them. If you form that habit, and not from restaurants and things. See, everything, you get it in the market, bring it home, and just shove it into thing and give them. For children, be careful. Once you spoil their stomachs, it's difficult to make them all. So be very, very careful as to what kind of food you are giving. Even if you have to give something, then you should read what is in it. If there are anything artificial things, please try to avoid. These are very precious children we have, and we have to look after them. Again and again, I would request you to be very kind to me by looking after them in a proper, sensible manner. Till they are with you. Also, you have to give them some discipline. It's very important. By giving them self-esteem, you are Sahyogis, you are this. If you give them, they have no self-esteem at all. If you give them the self-esteem, you'll be surprised they start behaving very well. By saying that, see, you are special children, you are Sahyogis. You can't behave like that. How they have to be. There has to be some discipline. Otherwise, at the age of 6 years, you cannot start. And even if you start it, it takes some time. It's exhausting, absolutely exhausting. Some children are very exhausting. So I hope you remember this. You have to be kind and nice, discreet, sweet to them. But first we should know what is going to be helpful to them, what is benevolent for them. And just some book comes about children, you read it. In Sahaja Yoga, you don't have to read all such books. I'm already going to write and I've already told you these things. Just in a wider way, you use your discretion. After all, you are all realized source and the spirit within you has seen the light of that, what is good for your child. But avoid tinned fruit as far as possible. Anything tinned is horrible and please don't take that for your children. I think you people all need not also have tinned fruit. What is the need? This cancer and all that, so rampant. In the West, in India, thank God at least, whatever poor they may be, they don't eat tinned fruit. We can't afford. Tinned fruit is more expensive in India than fresh fruit because tin is expensive, luckily. All right. So now, this is we have done. I have a little present for your leader. You are running short of one pen, so I borrowed his. And he said that, Mother, you have already given me a pen. Yeah, forget. I hope I have never given you a watch. Your watch, so you can send it. All right, this is one. Okay. And today is his wife's birthday. So let us sing something for her and a little present for her. May God bless. What a nice day to be here when it's your birthday. May God bless. Now, last but not the least, very important thing is that the senior people in Sahaja Yoga should not be called by their names. You can say uncle or something, Uncle Tom is to be done. It's very important. And even I have heard some Indian girls calling somebody John. I said, what? He's like your father. How can you call like that? Our husbands insist. Please. Call them with some sort of an uncle and auntie. Shouldn't say that. It's not proper. Doesn't look nice. Or address to elders, always sir. It's a better idea. Shows we have some culture. We are not brats, first of all. And also we are not people who are hippies. See, we have to respect the elders. Very important. It is that we have to respect all the elders that are within you. That's how you will be respected also. See to it those ladies or gentlemen who are senior people, always call them by either Mr. or Uncle or Aunt. He was all the time with me, but I somehow or other sneaked out time. Beautiful. Suits your hand very well. It's really very elegant. Very, very elegant. All right. So on a very happy note, we should end up now. I feel very sorry that I have to leave you all here. And there are people waiting, as you know, in the Eastern Asian countries for me, counting every minute. So I have to go. Thank you.
Srimad, before you go, it's not quite over. We have a little presentation for you.
Ah, no. You see, you can't.
Although it is your...
It's not my birthday.
No, Srimad. But as it is the month of March, Srimad, we feel that we can celebrate your birthday in a small way, if we may.
Oh, ma. It's the beautiful. I think you better do it for
it's
me.
It's a map of Australia.
Is it?
Yes.
Ah.
May God.
May God bless you. Thank you. So beautiful it is, so beautiful. Now come along, all the children. Come along, do for me. This side also. I'll be entering now my 70 years of age. Beautiful. You will have to read it out. How was that supposed to be? Tell it out. Huh? Yeah.
This is the card. To our beloved mother, it is you who is our shield. It is you who is the focus of our devotion. It is you who, as head of your worldwide Sahaja family, draws us together and envelops us with love and concern for one another. Beloved Sri Mataji, we, your children of the great Southland, wish you a happy, gracious and triumphant beginning to your 70th year. On behalf of all your children, I bow to your lotus feet.
And the second part of very
and
nice.
A little piece on the side. We vow to you to spread your work to live the precepts of Sahaj. We vow to you to live as one, a great society of saints at large.
Thank you very much. Beautiful, beautiful. Children, you must see what Austrians have sent me, beautiful things. They wanted me to be there for my birthday, but I don't know how I'll do it. In any case, you can have a look at the way they have wished me. Oh, this is very beautiful. Children have done it?
Yes.
Oh, why? I don't know what to say because pearls are the adoration of the Sastrara, you know that. There are stones on different chakras of which every chakra is made, and the pearls are for the Sastrara. It's so beautiful of you to think of that. It's really kind. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now you bought it, but I am now going to cancel also pearls from my list.
I want
final thing, Shivala, you travel so much. You have so many things to remember. We noticed you looked at one of these and you thought it might be useful.
But I need somebody to operate it. Just imagine, huh? Budget planning, period. What a joke, eh? Now then listen. Morning meetings. As soon as you come out of your bed, it starts. Then lunch engagements. Plan next meetings. Then interviews. Finished.
Not for those, Shirala, but for telephone numbers and all those sort of things that you have to keep somewhere.
It's quite a lot of things, I must say. I'm very bad at it, but somebody has to look after it because I don't understand how will I work it out. So
yes,
2,590 names and numbers and 1,820 scheduled appointments. Large 40 character by 8 line display. What are these characters, sir?
We have one appointment to put in there straight away, Shimala, and that is for the early part of next year in Australia.
Best part is that built-in help screens available for major functions at the touch of a button. But how do you find the button? You see, these buttons are so soft, you just touch anywhere they work. Alright, so thank you very much. I hope I'll learn something. Thank you very much. Thank you. These are donuts?
Fisher
rolls. Huh? Fisher rolls. Oh, my. Okay. Nobody has eaten so far. I'm the only one. Very well done. Thank you very much. I must thank you all for really making everyday new things for me, taking so much trouble looking after me so well. I feel very comfortable all the time with my children. And I was driven around in a very comfortable car. I've really enjoyed. And I don't look as if I've done the tour already. I'm quite fresh.
Disappeared strangely, Shimala. We none of us quite know how it came about, but it's all bits of Australia. We thought you might like it. It's a calendar.
Ah.
Snowy mountains. Doesn't look real, does it?
It's very nice. What colors? Very colorful country. Just imagine. Unbelievable. It's beautiful. Thank you very much. Beautiful photographs. I will take your leave now.
Shri Adi Shakti Bhagwati Mata Shri Nirmala Devi Ki Jai! Ki Jai!